What's it been like to have her kind of be the den mother of this group?
Great. And I mean, we could do worse.
Yeah. Oh my god.
She's amazing. She brought us like gifts.
Yeah.
She brought us all these like little parasols, and she brought me some books. Did she bring you some books?
She brought books, juices.
Juices.
She's dreaming. But more than that, like just feeling like there's like such a supportive, like she's like the main structure that just keeps mm-hmm. everything together. And even like being in a place like this, like yesterday when we were on that ride and she was like stood in front of all the cameras and she was like, this is not flattering photo for these women. And yeah. she's like our protector.
She is.
And I really love that. Like I feel like being a part of the show and having someone that can, that does that for us is like unbelievable. And she's fucking doing it for us.
Yeah.
So there's that. So there's that.
So what I love about
I know we're not close enough.
We're so needy.
What I'm
very
a little scary. I don't blame
really
you. We've been here for 4 days, so if we frighten you, we're sorry.
No.
What I love about horror movies is it's about the survivors, and the survivors are not who you might normally think would survive. Yeah. Not the big strong guy.
Yeah.
It's usually a girl, and usually the shy, unpopular girl no one ever thought of before. So it was that significant to you approaching a horror show?
I think we all kind of just went into it. I don't think we really knew that people were going to solidly die each episode. Like, we were kind of like, oh, you know, every couple episodes someone will die and it's not going to be us. And then Ryan's like, no, someone's going to die every week and none of you are safe. And we were kind of shocked. We were laughing about it. We're like, what do you mean? We thought we're not going to die. So all of us are kind of as in the dark as you guys, too, because Ryan will not tell us.
Yeah. You want to tell us, but it's so great too because like Ryan's always so smart with adding all the important elements to a show. It's funny, it's scary, but it also has that like kind of like girl power thing mm-hmm. about the show, which when he like pitched the show to me, I had zero information, but then like the more we talked and he was really, you know, the certain things that he was saying about what was important about the show, and it goes back to like you saying, like at the end, like maybe it'll be us girls who survive, like or take this yeah. like, killer down.
Yeah,
and, like,
totally.
I love that, and I love that Ryan always keeps that, you know, in mind, well, that it'll be a positive show.
Now that you're on the ride, and you know, obviously you trust Ryan implicitly, but so the as you're doing it now, what are you loving about this experience? What's been just, you know, blowing you away about this experience?
For me personally, I mean, I've always loved their writing, and I've always loved being a part of something that's so fresh and new, and I've had the same experience with Glee. I'm so excited right now to be playing a character that they're challenging me so much, Ryan, Brad, and Ian, and that's incredible. But I'm also so grateful to be working with such a strong group of actors who have such established careers and talents, and like that's just so great to work with other people that are so incredible. Yeah.
I mean, for me, just to be honest, and I'd known Ryan Murphy for a long time because he's friends with my aunt, and you know, I've known him just through the business. But then I always wanted to be on a Ryan Murphy show, and I was like, I want to be on American Horror Story more than anything. And I didn't even like ask him about it. One day he called me, and I was like, I didn't even ask you because I just didn't think there would be a role for me. And he's like, no, I have a role for you. So the fact that he like has yet again called me with an amazing role, and also to work with someone like him, who's a guy who can write for women so well. Mm-hmm. And makes us, you know, smart and articulate yeah. and funny. And, you know, I mean, the show is mostly young women. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, and Jamie Lee Curtis's role is amazing. And it's just really cool to be able to trust someone like him to make all of us girls look good. And yes. to know that, like, you know, you're going to have a badass role. I mean, that's how I felt on Coven. Like, it was yeah. so fun on Coven because literally he just made us all, like, badass, and then it was really awesome. I loved the experience.
Lea, how elaborate is the contraption you're wearing on the show?
It's pretty intense, I will say. And at first I was like, oh, this is nothing. Like, I can totally do this. Babe, you can share with me.
Okay, I'm so thankful.
And then...
Oh, she's
okay. Oh, I took it. I'm so sorry. Thank you. It's definitely very intense, especially late nights, and then you're just like, oh my god, but I know how to take it off within like 0.2 seconds, so...
How are you guys with actual horror films? Do you love them, or do you watch them like this? Like
love.
I'm like this.
Love.
My friends won't even watch horror movies with me anymore. They won't invite me to see them because they're like, one of us will have to sleep over at Emma's house yeah. if we take her to watch the movie.
Totally.
I'm like, you guys. And they're like, we're not seeing The Conjuring because he will make us move in. It's like, okay, true.
And then that's the, true. For me, it's like the opposite. It's
the
like
trailer scared me.
So scary. Then my girlfriends are like... if we come over to your house, we're not watching a scary movie with you because they don't want to. And they're like, oh, well, if we go on a weekend trip together, you can't make us watch it. I literally search, like, Apple, like, trailers to see, like, what new horror films are coming out and, like, what can scare me, like, because it's very hard to scare me.
So what are some films that did scare you, and what are your favorite horror films, whether they got you or not?
I mean, The Ring. I'm still traumatized. That was also such a good, like, scary movie. Because, like, psychologically, I'm still traumatized from that movie.
Yes.
Which I think is what makes a good scary movie, right? So, yeah, that, I mean, Poltergeist. Scarred.
How old are you?
I'm a baby.
Oh, my God.
I'm a baby. I'm terrified.
It is really scary, even though it's PG.
That's right. Poltergeist is PG?
Yeah.
That's so crazy.
The original one?
No, the original Poltergeist is PG.
Yeah, the new one's PG-13.
That is the craziest thing I've ever
heard. That's crazy.
The Sixth Sense?
Really? Oh my, I still can't. I check under the bed every night. And I'm, and it takes
you think
me,
that Misha Barton's underneath it?
No, and it takes me 5 minutes to get the courage up, too.
No, I think this, the most recent movie that was super scary was The Conjuring. But in years past, obviously The Ring, but The Strangers, man.
The Strangers, no. That was really
when they were like,
scary.
Why? And they were like, because you were home.
Okay, seriously? You're going to make me cry right now.
And they killed Ben from Felicity, and that was just like...
I know, God. Okay.
Have either of you ever had a moment where you're like, am I in a horror movie where something's going down and you are so scared because you feel like something creepy is just... happening?
Like every night when I'm alone in my house. Like every time that like I turn the lights off and at night to go to sleep, I'm like, are there ghosts in this room? Yeah. Like, are no, this like every day?
When, are you kidding me? When I go to my place in New Orleans, because it's really scary. Uh-huh. Sometimes I come home and I get a vibe, and I'm like, please, I have a long day of work tomorrow.
Yeah.
Like, can you relax? Because you're scaring me. And it stops.
But
there's definitely some stuff
out loud for
sure. In New Orleans.
So, Emma, has your character done something personally to rot this killer? Because sometimes there's often a sorority queen who scorns someone.
I am the president of the sorority, and I'm sure there are plenty of people I've pissed off enough to go on a killing spree.
Yeah.
But you know what I love about the show is, and I think we were all saying this yesterday, is that you don't really know who's good and who's bad, and everybody
right.
is very layered of, like, everyone has kind of done something that is bad, and everyone mm-hmm. has, you know,
potential.
Shades of good.
Yeah.
But everyone has that darkness. Like, there's always that little twinkle of darkness in everyone's eye, and that's why I genuinely don't know who the killer is. Like, I'm annoyed that they won't tell me.
I know.